Hey, welcome back to the channel. This is Kevin Wilson, SBC. Want to spend a quick few minutes building on the last video where we talked about a poor man mod on the front end limiters, manually limiting rise with a poor man's trick, but keeping safe at the same time. Speaking of safety with drag racing, launching your car, driving that car down the track, keeping it between the lines, off the guardrail, out of the concrete, whatever you want to call it, keeping it out of the driver and car you're racing, I want to talk about two things: eliminating the rag joint, and second, consider adding a steering stabilizer shock. And these two are very much related. I want to warn you now, I do share a video, a brief couple seconds of a crash from some very good friends of mine, Mike Hyatt and Bobby Turner, in a beautiful 69 Camaro many years ago. And it always did very impressive wheel stands. And on this instance, when it came down, the wheels went into a pretty serious death wobble. It sheared the rag joint. The car went left into the guardrail. Bobby was fine. The car was hurt. Everyone was shook up, obviously, from that event. But the safety equipment did its job. Let's talk about how to avoid that. It is absolutely critical, guys, that we keep our cars down the track, out of the rail, and out of the other driver. So I want to heavily caution you. You need to consider getting rid of that rubber rag joint and go into a mechanical joint. And then I want you to consider adding a steering stabilizer shock to control any wheel wobble you're going to get when you set those wheels down. So let's take a look at some of the things we did on the 48 Ford, and you guys see what you think. Do me a favor, like and subscribe to my channel, please. Thanks, guys. So let's talk about what's going on here and what am I so adamant about. I want you to take a look at this steering shaft that comes out of the firewall and goes down to the steering box, just a manual GM steering box. You will not see a rubber rag joint anywhere in this system. From the steering wheel, through the firewall, to the steering box, is all solid. Why do we do that? Well, take a look at this video and see what happens when you have a rag joint. You get a steering double D shaft. We run double D shafts. You can do spline. You can do whatever you want. There are so many different combinations you can set this up. But what you're looking at here is a 3/4 inch double D shaft, steel for steering, with two heavy duty steel double D joints. No rubber. Now, guys, these are not foolproof. These double D joints eventually require maintenance. However, they are much more heavy duty than a rubber rag joint. I see a lot of guys take these, especially on Mustangs, cut the rag joint off, get a double D joint, and tack weld it on, or weld it on for that matter. And you can do that, but if you ever have to replace or do maintenance on that double D shaft, well, you created a little more challenge there. However, these are easy to replace. Now, second thing we do is steering stabilizer shock. What you have here, this is not special. This is not for a G-body. This is just a heavy duty steering stabilizer shock. And we adapted it to our car. Let me see if I can get some better light. You can see it better here. These are heavy duty. This is attached to the drag link bar. And then the other end attaches to a bracket that is welded to the frame. And this stabilizer shock takes a lot of wobble, any death wobble attempt, anything that tries to happen with the front end of this car when you set the wheels down from a wheelie or from sudden acceleration or sudden stopping. This is going to keep control to a large degree the front end of this car. You can see many, many race cars have what appears to be the start of a death wobble. And I've seen many cars lose control and go into the wall or other drivers because of death wobbles. And what I want you to understand is on our car, there is all solid feedback from the steering wheel to the steering box, and then a steering dampener to control any type of violence that attacks the front tires. It's going to try to keep that front end under control. And what you can see, excuse the mess because we got a lot of welding going on here. From the steering shaft, where we lock in our steering wheel, all the way through to the firewall. Is solid all the way through to the steering box. No rubber rag joints. And then steering stabilizer shock. Got the front mounted fuel cell, guys. We also have a 1.5 steel roll bar that will come off each side of the frame, come in front here, and then make a 90 back to the other frame to protect the fuel cell. We're debating on eliminating the electric fuel pump at this point because we're running dual dominators on methanol, and we're considering going with a belt driven fuel pump. And since we're running a roots blower, the belt driven fuel pump simply attaches to the front of the blower pulley and would extend past the blower pulley just enough to run a belt to the pump. So that's kind of where we are, guys, with the 48 right now. Wanted to share some steering information with you that we consider absolutely critical, and real soon coming, front coilover double adjustable shocks and how to set them up with the rear double adjustable coilover shocks.
I really hope that makes sense. I know this could be pretty controversial. Everyone could have many different opinions about this. And I just want to say, I'm talking drag racing. I'm not talking about street driving, etc. Now, even on our street cars that are more high performance, we do this. We don't always add a steering stabilizer shock, but with the kind of wheel stands we had going on with this Ford before the blown motor, we felt it necessary to put a steering stabilizer shock on this car to keep control of those front wheels when they set down. So hopefully this made sense. Like I said in the beginning, please like and subscribe to my channel. Once again, this is Kevin Wilson, SBC. Thanks for watching my videos.